And welcome to this edition of Panther News Nation. I'm Lydia Broadbeck.
And I'm Daniela Velasquez. Here's what's happening around Principia this week. Every year, a group of upperclassmen travel to South Africa over spring break to help feed, clothe, and educate underserved communities there. It's known as the Simunye Trip. And as fellow Shreyas and Josh show us, it's a unique opportunity to be a positive force for change.
Trip had an unusual hiccup occur. Josh and Parth report on the eventful night.
So guys, Shreya's in Bell left her faucet on the whole night, and look at this.
Oh my god.
We're never gonna come back here. The Simunye project is gonna be banned.
They left the tap on and they left the plug in.
Bell and Shreya's room have been completely flooded. It is absolutely a nightmare.
Employee from the hotel comes running out and ask Mrs. Dry, who's in room 112? I look over at Shreyas and make eye contact with him. It's us, that's our room. And then we rushed upstairs to our room because they asked for us. And it turns out that our room was flooding. The entire hallway was soaking.
All right guys, let's check out my room right next door.
Oh no!
And immediately we started working. We started grabbing towels, sheets, blankets, all on the ground, soaking up, wringing them out. And then eventually everyone came to help and trying to prevent Mrs. Dry's wrath. But it was too late. Mrs. Dry already knew.
Whose is this?
Oh, that's mine.
But it turns out that Mrs. Dry was very happy that we were all working together. Kind of like showed like the idea of Simunye, like everyone coming together to help I'm serious. It did show the idea of Somalia. Josh recording the whole thing, right? You had people vlogging it. You had people making like commentary, and you had people who were like actually helping the ring out, grabbing their towels and their blankets to help out. At the moment, the worst moment in my entire life, right? Turns out that everyone else was like laughing and somehow having fun in all this and finding the joy. All right, everyone, do not flood your hotel rooms, please, because it's not really actually funny, and Mrs. Dry will get very mad.
Back on campus, did you know we have our very own girls band? Skylar and Issa bring us more.
We started a band because we all like rock / grunge music and we all play instruments, so we're like, yeah, we should get together and do this.
We started our band because we all kind of like played different random instruments and we just kind of like all liked rock music, and like me and Andrew started bonding over that when we were roommates, and we decided that we should put those things together.
Originally it was just Zana, Lucy, and Anzu, but they invited me in to be a singer for their band. I was really excited to do that because, I don't know, I like to sing and I love rock as well, so I thought it was a good idea. We practice during sixth period, which is all of our study halls. That's when we're all kind of free. Zana, however, is like she has a class herself, so we kind of struggle with that, but at least three of us get that practice time together, and then sometimes we'll meet on the weekends as well.
I usually, since I know we're working on the same song, I definitely practice back at my dorm when I can, but sometimes I'm able to like come out of choir just so then I can like join them to play a bit.
I'd probably like to play In Bloom by Nirvana, but our like main song that we play as a band like right now is Black Sheep by The Metrics.
I also like Teenage Dirtbag too.
My whole family, it's like we always are really into instruments. It's just being able to have another reason to play is like really important to me.
It makes me wanna go to school.
This is Issa and Skylar for PNN.
And in sports this week, Emery and Derek bring us an up close and personal look at a girls' soccer practice.
So bring the energy, okay, let's work hard in that, that's all I'm looking for.
Back here, back here. Oh. Ball here. Here. Good work, Matt.
One, two, three!
Be Principia!
With me, I made some goals today.
Yeah, I know, she was scoring and I was scared of her.
I scored a goal too!
Yeah, she did!
Yay! Yeah. Yeah.
Spring break marks the beginning of Principia's track and field season. Here's Mark and Asuche with a look.
Good, much better. No reaching at all.
Principia's track and field teams went to state last year, and while they didn't bring home the trophy, we were all proud of how well they did.
We have the right attitude. I think it's more so of getting everyone on the team with the same attitude. I think we have some athletes here and there that, you know, work hard and been doing things in the off season. But if we can get everybody to get that same attitude and have that same determination, then we should be able to have success as a team. Three relay teams, our three sprint relay teams for boys and girls to get through the state. But honestly, we got the talent, we got the ability. It's just going to be us being able to consistently drop time week after week.
If we really stay committed and throughout the entire season grow together, I think we can really surprise some people and make our way to state. At the end of the day, we're all capable of coming to state, but it just matters, you know, who's ready to commit and who's ready to really show up.
It all takes dedication, and you know, if you want to become like at that certain level, it just takes time and patience.
Bonding more as a team and stuff like that, working together, pushing each other harder to do better, is going to help us and take us to where we want to be.
This is Mark and Azuche reporting for PNN.
The wacky, unpredictable weather continues in St. Louis. And of course, Holland, Michael, and Reed know how to make it even wackier.
Good afternoon, Panther News Nation, and welcome back to Principia's Local Weather Channel. I'm your host, Holland Thomas, and I hope everyone had a great March. You probably did if you didn't have Auburn winning the whole tournament. For those of you who traveled this spring, St. Louis welcomes you back with scattered thunderstorms and expected showers on Wednesday and Thursday. Unfortunately, we're still in the awkward phase where it's freezing in the morning and toasting in the afternoon, as we expect lows of 40s and highs of 70s. Now, for your viewing enjoyment, the producers actually have me live where the thunderstorm is supposed to be happening, but as far as I know, I don't feel any rain. Now, I'll be passing on to your international reporter, Michael Sadamba, who's literally out of this world.
Today, we're going to be going over how hot Venus is. Did you know Venus is so hot it could cook a pizza in 2.5 seconds? That's faster than any pizza oven on Earth. With temperatures reaching up to 864 degrees Fahrenheit, you won't need to preheat the oven, but don't forget to bring a pressure suit because the atmospheric pressure is almost 100 times that of Earth's. So if you can imagine, I'm under a lot of pressure. I won't say Venus is the place to plan your next vacation. If you're looking for an ideal weather condition, come back to us, the Weather Channel.
And that's our look at what's happening around Principia.
Make it a great week.